Hello. Hello, everyone. Good evening. Good evening. Can you see me? Can you see me right? Good evening, Carol, Penny. Hello. Good evening, Hannah. Rebecca is with us. Daniel. Georgina is here. Amanda. Good evening, Stephen. Ronnie. Can you actually see me? I can't see myself. Well, to be fair, I don't know actually how to see myself. Oh, yeah. Good. Good evening, Keith. Good evening, Mustafa. Oh, you tuned in on time. 10 o'clock. Good evening, Ron. Oh, Helen is with us. Good evening, Helen. Oh, gosh. What a day. Let's see. Ah, yeah, you can see. Oh, yeah, what I can do is, again, oh, hello, my wife. She's watching. I'll keep an eye on you. Let me see. If I go to our live streaming with my mobile phone, yeah. Oh, now I can see. I know it's a bit of, you know, the time gap in between what I'm doing and yeah, what you can see or what I can see. But that's fine. It's better than nothing. Better than nothing. Ah. Probably what Keith's saying. Are you back up with the drink again? I'm sure that's what you're saying to me. Yes, in a way. But I haven't actually touched any drinks, rather than you know, soft drink and lovely orange juice. Oh. Ah. How was your day, my dear brothers and sisters? What a lovely day. What a gorgeous day. The sunshine was brilliant, was not too hot, was not too cold. I think that was a perfect day for us to enjoy, to be fair. And being nearly locked down for several weeks, not doing any sort of, you know, proper activities. The old family decided to venture out today, because we felt it's so difficult, you know, it was too down. So we thought, hey, anyway, we should actually do something within the range, you know, not going too far or too extreme, reasonably well maintained, you know, activities. And that was for us to have the fish and chips. Yeah, you heard it right. You heard me right. Fish and chips, but by the seaside. So we went to today. We went to Southend-on-Sea. You know, Southend-on-Sea, where the play park, theme park. Yeah, theme park with lots of you know things that you can ride. Because that is one place where, you know, Stephen loves to go. And then when he was little, when he was, you know, much younger than now, he's 8 now, and then he behaves as if he's 18. Ugh. But when he was little, I think that was really good, because the parents could actually ride with your child for free. And then, of course, you know, it was mainly me. If that is a mild, you know, the ride, sometimes, you know, Helen might just go, but Stephen, being a boy, he usually go, he used to say, okay, daddy, yeah. So I had to actually ride something with him. But I have to say, I thoroughly enjoyed that. So, Southend-on-Sea, that is a lovely place. I didn't know that when when I was in Colchester, I didn't know that Essex is full of, stuff that you can enjoy. There are so many things in Essex that you can actually do as a family. And one of the things that I love to do, I think this is kind of, you know, a lovely season because, you know, before you go into the really hot summer, when we have a, you know, beautiful, you know, the strawberries, you know, coming out, and we used to go to a strawberry farm for strawberry picking. And one particular farm that we used to love to visit is it's just an ordinary farm run by the family. But the owner was really, really laid back. And that he used to say, well, the whole family, they used to say, well, just go and then just do whatever you want to do. If we go to a strawberry picking, you know, the farm somewhere in London, in North London, near here, they would say, oh, no. You only have one or two, you may have one or two to taste them, but you're not allowed to eat. Back in time, back in Essex, you just eat as much as you want. You just do whatever you want to do. You ended up eating so many strawberries there. And one day I think I ate so many, you know, the strawberries nearly nonstop. It's so sweet, and then you know the taste. If you just go to the farm, if you pick one or two, that is brilliant. It's so different from the strawberries that we can taste from the supermarket ones. But anyway, that was wonderful. And then that was a course. That was the next thing that we used to do. We used to go to the Mersey Island or even the Clacton somewhere, and then we had to have an ice cream. Straw picking, a bit hot, you know, enjoy, relax, and then you go to a Mersey Island or let's say the Clacton, you eat some ice cream, play a bit, or go to Mersey and then do some crabbings and then an ice cream. Ah, that is really, really good thing. And also, I'm a big fan of, you know, the Colchester Zoo. I think that is, if you haven't been there with, the parents, that is a place that I would thoroughly recommend. Of course, you know, I heard people saying, well, the Colchester Zoo is much, much better than London Zoo or any other zoos around in this area. And yeah, that was we used to have the card, the membership card, and used to spend, how many times we visit there. And they used to have a lovely cafe, a lovely restaurant, and then they used to serve handmade jacket potato. Oh, I know, but if you are on your diet, where is your father, Vince? Are you with us tonight? on the diet. So, and then, that is the good memories. But I didn't know that when I was in Essex, it was full of, you know, interesting things. And then as Stephen grows up, and he's now seven, eight, that age, still Essex, you know, offers, us, the whole family, the wonderful things, to do. Yeah, the best zoo. I think, David said, fish and chips, traditionally English meal on a Friday. Yes, that is true. And actually, the fish and chips is, the reason why the English people having, fish and chips on a Friday is always linked with the Christianity. Yeah, Christianity. It's, if you go to, the place where I was trained to be a priest, that is, let's say, in Stephen's house in Oxford, and that is one of the theological training colleges, which is first established as, it's gone. After the Henry VIII, the time, so it has a long tradition. But if you go there on Friday, even if you stay there as a guest on the breakfast, you are not going to be served with cooked breakfast, because Friday is the day you avoid any meat, and then therefore you have naturally the natural salad or non-meaty food, vegetarian-ish or the vegan-ish, yeah, that sort of, the food that you have. And then that's why, in many Christians, families, having fish on Friday, yeah, that has been tradition. So it's wonderful. But today, we have a caravan in Clacton. Only one downside in Essex. Is the seaside, the shore, the sea area is not really famous for fishing. It's not bad, but like Canvey Island, I caught the lovely during the night fishing. I caught I've been there several times now. I caught a lovely good size schoolie bass, but you're not allowed to keep the bass anyway. So you have to release them, but that was a good catch. But I don't think the Mersey Island or the Clacton or even further up, that's a good the famous the place for shore fishing. So that is one the downside. But Clacton, you can't you can't miss the Clacton. And also, of course, if you go to Colchester, you must visit. You must go to the Castle Park, especially if you go to the Upper Park. If you go there, you will see the beautifully maintained, the Rose Garden. But anyway, and also, before I say anything, if you go to Colchester, you must actually visit the St. James the Great. That is on the top of the Easter Hill. So if you come out of the Castle Park, the Upper Park, there is a lovely gate. If you see left, that's the East Park, or East side of the Colchester. And if you see right, coming out of the park gate, and then that's town centre. But if you see the east side, and on the top of that, there is a church. Beautiful, the 12th century, the church where I served my title. That means I was there, the curate for 3 years. That's a wonderful place, a brilliant place. A good place to visit, lovely pub food. Town centre is very tiny and has a full of character. It's a lovely place to to visit. So don't forget to pop in to see that lovely church as well. Father James McCluskey now, he is director there in the parish, even came to my induction when I was appointed as a vicar, not as a priest in charge, and several years ago, and he also came. So it was much appreciated. I have to say big thank you now to Father James and all the good faithful people in Colchester. We used to have one or two people tuned in, but I'm not sure whether we have anyone today, maybe quietly watching of us. But anyway, so the Friday, perfect day to enjoy the weekend. And then I've got something to show you. Promise me that you are not going to laugh. And then, to be fair, this is not my idea. This was not my idea. This was Helen's idea. I think this is absolutely perfect for me to share this with you on Friday. But before I show you, I have to switch off the light. So give me a second. I'm going to switch off the light. I'm sure you won't be able to see me. Maybe you can, because of the monitor light. What I have got is this. Now, where is it? Yep. Ding. Oh, nope. 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 How can I switch on? Someone help me. Oh.
The Bluetooth device is ready to pair.
Come on. Ah, yeah, it's now coming. Can you see this? It reflects, it reacts with my voice or any sort of a sound. So imagine that. If you play any sort of disco music, not a ghost, not a spooky things. Ah, look at that. So this is the one of the things that I wanted to share with you. Yes, disco light, disco light. I know it looks silly, but let me see. Where's my guitar, by the way? Let's see whether this one will actually work with my guitar sound. Yeah? Oh. Yeah, Friday night. Now I can see, I'm sure this one works now. So what I can do is, hang on a minute, let me just go for, I may able to sing a song with you. Okay, let's fingers crossed. I hope this one works. Who cares? It's a Friday. It's a Friday. I've been to the sea. I had a lovely fish and chips, so...
You said the place I had went to my
I'm sorry, I had to actually try this because, yeah, we bought, oh, hang on a minute, it's a steel flashing. Oh, yeah, it's a lovely disco bowl. How do I switch off? I will never actually get it. Okay, switch off, switch off, switch off. Oh, I'm going to switch off here. So, because we bought this one, so that we may actually have a bit of, you know, the inline skate, roller skate, the evening, well, yeah, afternoon with the children in the large hall. I know it's impossible. We can't do it, you know, at the moment. But hopefully, one day we may be able to actually have a bit of, a fun time together. Of course, if we do, roller skating or inline skating, we have to make sure that our children, they're wearing, protective gears, and we need to actually control the numbers, blah blah blah, etc. Health and safety, of course, But still, if we have this sort of, light bulbs. That's going to be brilliant. Of course, there are some people like even in among our community, there are some good proper DJs. But even this is small one that will actually help me and my wife and Stephen to giggle. I think that's why Helen got this one from Amazon a couple of days ago. So I wanted to actually show you about that. Ah, good. Now, what we are going to do now is I'm going to sing, we're going to sing a song to end this week. This week has been, very interesting week. Good news, bad news, especially yesterday we had, a lovely time with, by watching the video that we sent to the Mary Dwyer. And we enjoyed her message, and what a wonderful man. And I had a chance to talk to some member of community today, and yesterday. That was brilliant. It's so nice. And I think that is what we're doing, and that is a benefit of we forming this lovely community here on our Facebook page. Is there anybody? Let me see. Is there anyone who celebrates the the birthday? Yep. Let me just quickly go through the screen. So if you can put the names down. Oh. Yeah, Hannah said, this week has been exhausting for me, but yeah, I think you mentioned that you're going to have, two different jobs at the same time, but hopefully from next week, I hope everything goes a bit smoother. I'm sure next week will be much, much better. And then don't forget, we still have Saturday, tomorrow, Saturday, to enjoy. Anyone celebrating the birthday? Ah, your daughter turns 10 on Sunday. Oh, in that case, let us know, because we will do the thoughts for night on Sunday. So we're going to wait for her birthday until, Sunday. I think yesterday we celebrated, Susan's, the birthday. And then today is the birthday of her son, John. I think anybody's birthday today. I can't really see from my my screen. So if you have someone who's celebrating the birthday today, let me know, and I'll give you a couple of seconds, and then otherwise I will move to the next stuff that we are going to do. And then the next thing that we're going to do is, again, we're going to sing a song together. But I think the last time when I tried to put some screens up, I think that was quite good. So I'm going to do that again. Now I'm going to do it now. Hey, now let's see whether we can see this as a full screen. I'm sure you will all know this song This hymn, "The Lord's My Shepherd, I'll Not Want." I'm sure you're familiar with this, the melody. And we give thanks to our Lord for this, the wonderful day. And then we pray that not only us, but, the whole nation, everybody may have, the better the life. Soon we may able to, overcome the fear and danger of this, the coronavirus. I pray that even gloomy news of, the sad news of, the losing some people may not dampen our spirit here in freezing water. So we're going to sing this, Psalm 23, "The Lord's My Shepherd." And then again, my brothers and sisters, don't forget that this week is a special week, the prayer week called Thy Kingdom Come. And Thy Kingdom Come is all about, the sharing the good news with others. And I think what we are doing together is one of the best ways to share the joy of, Jesus Christ with others. Okay. Now, I'm going to sing, and then I'm sure you will be able to join me in singing. Come on, let me just change my couple. The Lord's my shepherd, I'm not one. He makes me lie in pastures green. He leads me by the still waters. His goodness restores my soul, and I will trust in you alone, and I will trust in you alone, for your endless mercy follows me. Guides my ways in righteousness, and he anoints my head with oil, and my cup it overflows with joy. I feast on his pure delight, and I will trust in you brothers and sisters, it is time for us to say... Thank God. It stopped there. Now it's a time not to be panic. It's a time for us to say some prayers. And as I mentioned earlier, this is, you know, Thy Kingdom Come week. So we are going to say the Lord's Prayer together. If you want to say the Lord's Prayer in your own language, that's absolutely fine. I would recommend you, to do so. I tried, actually, the Lambeth Palace, contacted me a couple of days ago, and that was, one of the team members of the Thy Kingdom Come. And then he asked me to make a short video, me saying the Lord's Prayer in Korean. I tried. Well, you're just using your mobile phone. You tried. I could not actually say the Lord's Prayer in Korean because I don't do that. So it's not really familiar. So I have to say Lord's Prayer in English at this point. But at some point when we actually celebrate, Pentecost on Sunday, I will actually encourage people to say the Lord's Prayer in their own language again at 10 o'clock service. And then I promise this time I will actually say the Lord's Prayer in Korean so that you may able to hear, different, the language saying the same prayers. But anyway, if you are happy to say the Lord's Prayer in your own language, that is absolutely fine. And I don't have anything with me, so forgive me, I will actually say in English. But again, let us say the Lord's Prayer, not in a rush, not in a rush. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. No, that's not a prayer, I think. That is just you recite a prayer really fast. And then this time we are going to say the Lord's Prayer a bit slowly. And at the end, we are going to pause just a bit and then just a short, the moment. And then we'll say Amen. Okay? Brilliant. Now, my brothers and sisters, we're going to say the Lord's Prayer, together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Oh, that's good. That's good. Yeah. If I say the Lord's Prayer slowly, I don't know why, but it's very different, isn't it? It's very different when you say, when you say a well-known prayer really quickly. You may actually catch all the meanings. You may observe all the meanings of that prayer, but sometimes I feel it's extremely hard. And then even when you say the Lord's Prayer, I'm sure some of you may actually realize that if you say the Lord's Prayer extremely slowly, sometimes you forget what to say. Yeah, but because you get familiar with a certain tempo. But I think sometimes the breaking that tempo and coming out of that style, particular style, is actually helping us to see the different meaning of that prayer, may help us to enjoy the different, the meaning of that, same prayer. So sometimes, from time to time, try this at your home, okay? And tonight's prayer, I think tonight we would love to actually, I'd love to actually, ask you to join me in saying the prayer for the confidence, for confidence. Why? Because next week, we're going to see our children. Some of our children will come back to the school, parish school here. I've noticed that now the school play area is all, taped. And on my fence, you will see some marks, 2 meter gaps. So we are nearly ready. And we have to actually continually pray for our teachers and the staff members of our school and of actually all schools for their safety and their service. I know whatever happens, I think what helped me personally, what helped me to go through all the difficulties in my short life is actually the confidence. Not confidence, being confident that I can do it. No, that's not me. But the confidence that Jesus will help me to go through it. Whatever situation that I am in, I know I have confidence, not in me, but in Him, in Jesus. So I think that we should actually pray for that confidence. So we can pray like this. Dear Jesus, tonight I pray for Kimberly, and she may have some confidence in her heart so that she may actually take you as a source of her confidence in her life. In Jesus' name we pray. And I pray for the Heather, and she may actually realize that she can rely on you, so that in the name of Jesus, she may have some confidence in her heart, which is coming from your son, Jesus. Amen. Something, some prayer, something like that. So when you finish, just don't go. Don't just, log off, tuned off. Just always check, the comments line, and go to one of your comments that you left, and then just check the comment, the people, person, two people who left the comment above you and below you, and you pray for two people, okay, for the confidence that we may have confidence in our heart. So, dear my brothers and sisters, it's a time for me to say, the goodbye now, and then, because the. And then I'm going to see you all tomorrow if you tuned in for Mass at 12 o'clock. And other than that, I will see you all on Sunday. The Sunday is, of course, it's a Pentecost. And then I will strongly recommend you to tune in to sit and then watch the service wearing something red. Because Pentecost, it's a tradition for us to wear the red color, red jackets, red blouse, whatever. But don't just tell me, okay, I'm wearing completely black and normal, nothing, the red on the top, but I'm actually wearing my red, underwear. I do want to see. Don't be silly. Apart from that, just wear something red, even red socks. I don't have red socks, actually. I should actually get one. As a something that you can celebrate, because the Pentecost is one of the most important and great and joyful, the day that we as a church to celebrate. So have a lovely evening, lovely night, and I should say goodbye, cheers, good night, and whatever is appropriate for you. And then tomorrow night we don't have thoughts for the night, and then therefore I'll see you when I see you again. Thank you for tuning in, and then may God bless you all tonight. Bye for now. Bye. Mm-hmm.